a common question that I often get is, why can't we use consumer-grade cameras or surveillance cameras? And why do we need specialized industrial cameras for machine vision projects? Hi, my name is Raghava Kashyapa, CEO of Qualitas Technologies. And in this video, I'm going to dive into the details of what constitutes the key difference between a consumer camera and specialized industrial cameras. At the heart of it all, both cameras really operate on a CMOS, what is commonly a CMOS sensor technology. A CMOS sensors is responsible for converting light energy of photons into electric energy or electrons, which is how digital pixels or images are formed in pixels. Now, the differences really are surrounding all the things that happen in the acquisition process. So even though the sensor technology, which is perhaps in your cell phone or your webcam or surveillance cam, is very similar to what you would see in industrial cameras, the differences are in a couple of different areas. One, it's a housing. Oftentimes, industrial cameras are very miniaturized so that they fit into small places. Surveillance cameras, on the other hand, are often bulky with housing, which is suitable for all weather conditions, especially for the outdoor. The other common difference is in the acquisition of frame rate. So with surveillance camera, the purpose of surveillance and other consumer-grade cameras would be to really visualize a video or some still images. So the human eye can differentiate frame rates of up to 60 frames per second, which is often good enough as a temporal resolution when you're looking at the videos in a sequence. But in the case of industrial use, you would often come across high-speed application lines which demand higher frame rates, often in the hundreds of frames per second. The third difference is in the programmatic access to controls within the camera. So with industrial vision, it's fully automated in the sense that you would have some upstream or downstream automation which is integrated with your camera technology. So you often have external triggers which programmatically acquire images, or you may also have outputs which programmatically define certain signals which can communicate with external devices like PLCs and controllers. With consumer cameras, these are generally absent. Another key difference is the range in which you actually have sensors as well as resolutions. With surveillance or other kind of consumer-grade cameras, the purpose again is to visualize and see how it looks to the human eye. But with industrial cameras, it's not how it looks to the human eye, but how clear the feature or the features of contrast of interest are to the image processing software. And that's when things like different quantum efficiencies, different sensor sizes, different pixel sizes, and even differences like the shutter types, being global shutter, rolling shutters, make a key difference in acquiring quality images which are clear to the software, not just to the human eye. So these are some of the differences, and I hope I've been able to convey some points which justify the use of industrial cameras. And the next time you're going in for a machine vision project, do keep these in mind. It may seem that a consumer-grade camera could be well suited for your application, in which case, do go ahead. But it's these differences which often makes the difference between success and failure of a project, in which case, it's better to go with an industrial camera. Thanks.